The next part of this lecture concerns reaction coordinate diagrams. We are finished with the first part of thermochemistry, which considers the energy of only the initial and final states, but does not tell us what reaction path is taken or how fast the reaction will occur. We are now moving to kinetics, which considers the reaction path taken and describes the rate of the reaction. Let's consider the process of burning octane in your car. Octane is a hydrocarbon that reacts with oxygen to make carbon dioxide and water. This is a very exothermic process at standard state, at roughly minus 5,000 kilojoules per mole of liquid, and it produces a great deal of gas, so the entropy change is positive, which means the Gibbs free energy change at standard state is negative, so the reaction is extensive and prefers product. Delta G is also negative, so the reaction is spontaneous. So why does the car still need an ignition source to begin the burning of the octane? A simple answer: energy of activation. A reaction coordinate diagram is where we can begin to think about the pathway taken to the reaction. On the x-axis is the reaction coordinate, so it is the progress going from reactant to product, and on the y-axis is the energy level of each stage. Many reactions are reversible. They can go in the forward direction or the reverse direction. This is a reaction coordinate diagram for which we are going down from reactant to product. So if we look at the energy change, the delta G naught at standard state is negative. However, in order to run a reaction, first we need to break reactant bonds, which requires energy, before we form new product bonds. The process of breaking reactant bonds is known as the energy of activation forward. Going forward, this hill must be climbed in order to get to product. If we think about the reaction being reversible, then to go backward from product to reactant, there is also a hill to climb. This is the energy of activation reverse. What is at the top of the hill? The transition state. This is short-lived, unstable, and made of partially formed and partially broken bonds. Many times the existence of the transition state is hypothesized. Other times there are very fast measurement techniques that can be used to actually capture some details of the transition state. We're going to start with a very simple reaction. It's reversible, and this is hydroxide ion reacting with methyl iodide to make methanol and iodide. There are some specifics to the reaction in which the hydroxide must come in exactly opposite the carbon-iodine bond. When it does so, it kicks the iodine out to make the iodide ion and forms a carbon-oxygen bond. Here's a short animation that helps you understand what's going on in the reaction.
Primary halogenoalkanes undergo SN2 reactions, where the S denotes a substitution reaction, the N shows the reaction involves a nucleophile, 2 is the number of species involved in the slowest rate-determining step. A nucleophile is an electron pair donor. It is attracted towards species carrying a full or partial positive charge, with which it can form a dative covalent bond. Consider the reaction between a hydroxide ion in solution and bromoethane. Both reactants are involved in determining the rate of the reaction in a one-step process. The hydroxide ion attacks the carbon atom from the opposite side to the halogen atom because the bromine atom A is so large it impedes the approach of the smaller hydroxide ion, and B, it repels the negative charged nucleophile. The lone electron pair on the nucleophile forms a new dative covalent bond with the partially charged carbon atom to give an unstable transition state complex. The complex behaves like an umbrella blowing inside out as the bonds rearrange into a tetrahedral structure. A bromide ion, called the leaving group, is released.
Those of you on your way to organic chemistry now know a typical organic reaction, the SN2 substitution. So as I've tried to capture in this slide, the transition state is something that has partially formed and partially broken bonds. And when we go forward, we go through the transition state. And as the reaction is reversible, one also goes through the same transition state. So that transition state will be at high energy. In fact, it's at higher energy than either the products or the reactants. Running a reaction, even a spontaneous one, requires energy to start. The difference is that some reactions have a huge hill and some reactions have a tiny hill, and that will impact how quickly the reaction occurs. Continuing with this idea, which way does it require less energy to do the reaction, forward or reverse? So I like to imagine two people, you and your friend, are going to climb the hill from opposite directions. Which one of you will spend less energy to climb the hill? Well, if we look at the energy barrier forward, it is less than the energy barrier in reverse. So obviously, you, going forward, will expend less energy than your friend who's trying to go in reverse. So energy of activation forward is less than energy of activation reverse. Now let's look at speed. Which way does it look faster to do the reaction, forward or reverse? Imagine you and your friend run at approximately the same pace. Which one of you is going to reach the top of the hill faster? Well, you are. So that means that the forward rate constant is greater than the reverse rate constant. You will reach the top of the hill faster than your friend. Here is a student question for you with a reaction coordinate diagram. I would like to know what is energy of activation forward, energy of activation reverse, and delta G for the reaction coordinate diagram. In case you're a little confused about how to answer this, the energy of activation forward is going to be your energy of transition state minus your energy of reactant. Your energy of activation reverse is going to be equal to your energy of transition state minus the energy level of the product, and delta G will be your energy of product minus energy level of reactant. Now I'm asking you, if you have 84 kilojoules of energy, how many times can the reaction run forward and reverse? For those of you who might be confused, the times you can go forward would be 84 divided by your energy of activation forward from the previous question. The times one can go in reverse would be 84 divided by your energy of activation reverse from the previous question. I asked this series of questions so that students would realize that when you have a diagram in which energy of activation forward is greater than energy of activation reverse, the rate constant forward is less than the rate constant reverse. A large energy of activation forward means a small forward rate constant. These two terms are inversely related. That brings us to this question. Which diagram below has the largest forward rate constant? To answer this, you need to think, do I need a large hill going forward or a small hill going forward in order to have the largest forward rate constant? Here is a summary of the different reaction coordinate diagrams. When the topic was introduced, delta G naught was negative. We had a diagram that was lower on the product side than on the reactant side. That means energy of activation forward is less than energy of activation reverse, and rate constant forward is greater than rate constant reverse. For this type of diagram where delta G naught is negative, we say the reaction is extensive and prefers the product side. For your series of questions, you were given a diagram in which delta G naught is greater than zero. In this diagram, energy of activation forward is greater than energy of activation reverse, and rate constant forward is less than rate constant reverse. Because delta G naught is positive, we say this reaction is non-extensive and prefers to remain on the reactant side, which is the low energy side of this diagram. Then, of course, one can be in the middle, where delta G naught is equal to zero. The energy of activation forward will be equal to the energy of activation reverse, and the rate constant forward will be equal to the rate constant reverse.